Kasi I hope it can go straight to them, because I have a suggestion for them. First, in terms of tax management, they must discipline the one who implements the tax rule. I'm talking about the leader. Kasi if they have the integrity that we accountants are doing in private, no matter what institution, private, government, or non-government, then we don't have a problem with trust issues. Because the main thing that they evade taxes is a trust between the client or the companies or the commerce and industry to the government that they are dealing with. So the number one thing that the government must do is to discipline the tax implementers. Second is polish the clear tax law. As I mentioned a while ago, ang daming gray areas. And, you know, one tax rule is contradicting with the others. So there's a difficulty for us to interpret. Our interpretation as an accountant is different from the interpretation of the BIR officials. Mm-hmm. And that's the problem. Because even if I wanted to follow the rules, but my interpretation is different from them, and we have this conflict, what really matters is their interpretation. Okay? We do not go back to the what is the real intention of the low tax maker yet. They just give us their interpretation must be followed, and you have to pay this with penalties. They do not recognize that the accountant's interpretation is different from theirs. So there's no meeting of the minds in that area. Because for BIR, we are the tax implementer and you must know better than you. That's wrong. Because their responsibility is to equip accountants with so much knowledge. So we both have the same platform that we are doing. So imagine the conflict if the BIR officials knows that or thinks that they are better than the accountants. It must not. So we must have a standard platform, whether accountants of the government, accountants for the non-government organizations, and accountants of the commerce and industry or private institutions. We must have one language. The tax law must be clear, no gray areas, and they must have, I recommend this during the train law public hearing, that to publish a concise and brief summary of the tax rule, because the tax rule that you're reading right now might be amended in some areas and you don't know about it, because that's how progressive is the tax rule of the Philippines. So they must publish this one tax rule for this particular area, example income tax, amended by this one, and it's easily and recognizable by the accountants. So there's no conflict. There's no room for lagayan. Kasi gray area is a number one source of lagayan. The number three is the government should have a free educational campaign for all the accountants. As I've mentioned, you should have a solid knowledge of taxation, no matter what industry you are. So might be it on a government, an NGO, or commerce and industry, or the private institutions. You must have one solid interpretation, and you can handle that by having the government campaign of educational campaign for taxation.
BIR doesn't have that program yet.
They have the program, but pachi-pachi, like they implemented the train law. Only portion of that, if they are the amendment is because of income taxation for individuals. That's all. But there's no such thing as progressive campaign. Like, what's your campaign about providing basic knowledge about corporate income taxes? And it must be all throughout the year. Their campaign must really to support the accountants who competed for the taxes. Who are the mid-year are mediators between them and the clients. So if there's, imagine if there's this complaint, there's no reason for the accountants to say you're inadequate. We don't know. Because the platform are available, the laws are clear, no gray areas for another interpretations. We have the same language, and I think that's a sign of a progressive country.
There will be no reason for that.
Not to give and not to pay them the right taxes.
Mm-hmm. So what do you think will happen to our economy if the accountants or the bookkeepers or the tax agents pay the right taxes for their clients?
I think a progressive country like Singapore, like this. Mm-hmm. Because what hinders us is our values and our mindsets. Mm-hmm. Or some of the issues I mentioned before.
Mm-hmm. Mom, what is the role of the accountants regarding the betterment?
Imagine if there's a dilemma of the accountant doesn't know what they are working about or what they are doing, then this country will suck. Because as I mentioned, as you also asked, mediator tayo eh. So a mediator must be equipped with knowledge. So paano ko i-convey to my client if I'm not equipped, if I'm not competent? The number one campaign is the equipping the accountants with the proper knowledge, then everything will
come. What is your advice to accountants and taxpayers who do not pay the right taxes?
Well, maybe let them experience sana the beauty of being a righteous person. Because as I think about those tax evaders, they cannot sleep well in are paying the right taxes, you can sleep well at night. You can walk in the path that your head is up, something like that. You are not afraid of audits of the BIR because you're confident that your computation is right. You have the power to negotiate and refute the computations